Welcome to Hannon CAD Learning Channel.
In this video tutorial, I will talk about building solid geometry and meshing in the map program. To begin with, I will import a neutral file that contains the initial sketch on which our geometry will be based on the construction. For this, I go to File Command and import the map neutral and select slot file and click Open. This file is in the directory where you installed the FMAP in examples folder. I select the slot file and then click Open. Here I turn on the Reviews option to use the views that are currently configured in my graphics window. They use its views that were written in a neutral file. I click OK. So neutral file contains a set of curves that represent a sketch on the basis of which we will create solid geometry in order to extrude this sketch and create a solid part. You need to create a page surface boundaries or face. For this, go to Geometry and Boundaries Surface from Curves. Select all curves and press OK and next press Cancel. This is a bounded surface that C created and highlighted with a thick green line. Now I can extrude this surface using extrude command. To do this, go to the geometry and solid extrude. Here the boundary surface is already selected in the extrusion settings, and here I change the direction to negative and set the distance to 10 units. Press OK. Now in the project tree we have the first touching geometry in the form of a solid object. Then I need to create a pass for the key for this. I first create two circles and then connect them with lines in order to cut the sketch data along the contour in order to create. I go to the geometry tab and curve circle and radius. Here I indicate the coordinate of the center of the circle. 0 along x-axis, 95 along y-axis, 0 along z-axis. In the second box, I need to specify the point that will lie on the circle. I set the coordinate of the point. 11 along x-axis, 95 along y-axis, 0 along z-axis. Okay, next I am invited to create a second circle. Its center will be located at coordinate 0 along x-axis, 50 along y-axis, 0 along z-axis, and a point in the circle will have coordinate 11 along x-axis, 50 along y-axis, 0 along z-axis. Now I need to connect two points. For this I go again geometry and curve line and point. Select the first point and the second point and press OK. And build the second line in the same way. Then I need to split the circle into two arcs in order to remove the extra part. For this I will use the modify and break at location. I select the circle and press OK. And then I select the point which it needs to be split. For this I can use the snap to point. Right click with mouse and select snap to point and then select the point where the circle need to be split and press OK. I see that this circle has already been split into two arcs. And let's select the second circle and do the same operation. Then I need to delete the extra lines. For this, I will use the delete and geometry curve command and select the two extra curves and click OK. Then I am asked if I really want to delete these curves and I click OK. Now to create a cutout according to this sketch, I need again to compose the boundary surface. For this, I go to geometry and boundary surface from curves. And select these lines and press OK and cancel. The boundary surface is created. So I will use a geometry and solid extrude. Here I switch in material command to remove hole, and in direction select negative, and in boundary mode select through all and press OK. Now we will build the keys, then I need to create a hole for the bolts. For this I again go to geometry curve circle and radius. I give the coordinate of the center 1 in the circle minus 38 along axis X, 0 along axis Y, 0 along axis Z and press OK. And set the point on this circle with coordinate -38x and 5y and 0z and click OK and cancel. Now in order to again extrude according to this sketch, I need to create a boundary surface. Go geometry boundary surface from curves and select this circle and press OK. The boundary surface is created. Now I will use the command extrude. Go geometry solid and extrude. Here select the mode remove hole and negative and in boundary through all. And to not create several sketches, I will use the pattern button. I will select the circular array center. I will leave the default number of object with coordinate in center 0x and 0y, number 5 and the angle of 180 degrees and press OK then OK. And in one step I stretched 5 surfaces, then I need to extend grandmothers. For this I will create again auxiliary geometry in the form of a sketch. Go geometry curve circle and radius. Select the center of the circle with coordinates 0x, 0y, 0z and press OK and a point on circle 25x, 0y, 0z, press OK. Then create again a second circle with the same center and a point on the circle with coordinates 16x, 0y, 0z and press OK and cancel. Now again create a boundary surface. Go to geometry and boundary surface from curves and selecting two circles and press OK. Boundary surface is created, and then again I will use the command geometry solid and extrude. Note that the bounded surface is selected automatically. Here I switch to the mode Sat material and set the length to 50 units depth and press OK. Now we have grandmothers. I want to extrude a groove. For this I need to rebuild the work plane is available through the tools. Go tools command and select work plane, or you can just click F2 and the command work plane is affix. In order to switch the work plane to this surface in order to draw a sketch on it, I select on surface in the define plane option and select the surface. After we select the origin of the work plane and select the second point in the direction of the x-axis work plane and press OK. In order to display the work plane, I press F2 and check the box next to the draw work plane and press Done. So the work plane is built. Now I will build an auxiliary line for this. I go to on the geometry and curve line and point command. Select one point and the second one and press OK. Now I will use the command geometry curve line and parallel to offset the lines parallel to the one I just built. I select the line and set the distance to 3.5, press OK. Then, I am asked to set the direction in which direction I can move this line in order to get the direction. You just need to specify the point closest to this line. I will select this point and press OK. And the line will be demolished parallel in this direction in order to build second line. Again, select the line relative to which I want to shift in parallel and press OK, and here select the direction in the opposite and press OK and cancel. Now I will create a rectangle. Go to the geometry curve line and point, select two point and press OK, and similar on the opposite side and press OK and cancel. Now I need to create a boundary surface. Go to geometry boundary surface from curves, select four lines that form a rectangle and press OK. To hide the work plane so that it does not bother you, go to F2 and uncheck the draw work plane. Then use geometry command solid and extrude. Here select remove hole and put the depth 12 units and press OK. So I created a cutout. Then I need to delete the auxiliary geometry for this. I go to the delete geometry curve. Here I can select all the lines and press OK, then confirm the deletion and press OK, and lines that did not refer to other objects will be deleted. And similarly I delete points. Go to delete command geometry point, select all and press OK. I have completed lesson number 2 in geometry. Thank you for your attention and see you soon in the next lesson.